सोचा और इसको एक रूपरेखा दिया. चाहे नक्षत्र हो, चाहे पूरी स्पेस हो, जहाँ पे, और ये पराशक्ति, पराशक्ति मतलब आदि, आदि पराशक्ति, त्रिपुर सुंदरी, भुवनेश्वरी, और ये पूरे, जैसे अगर हम हिंदू हैं या कोई भी धर्म का कोई भी व्यक्ति हो, हम शक्ति पे ज़्यादा विश्वास रखते हैं और शक्ति ही पूरी सृष्टि को चलाती है. इक्वालिटी, जब हम समाज को बोलते हैं कि हमारा पूरा समाज एक कुटुंब है और समाज में सबको एक साथ मिलकर चलना चाहिए, तो समाज के हर एक घटक, ऐसा ना हो कि स्पेस मूवमेंट की बातें हो तो सिर्फ पुरुष ही देखे जाएं. हमारे इधर साइंटिस्ट औरतें भी हैं. अगर शक्ति का या स्पेस की बातें हो, भारतवर्ष में सभी को अपना स्थान और सभी के लिए एक अच्छा स्पेस क्रिएट करना चाहिए. ये प्रोग्राम जो रिसेंटली भारत ने अपनी सुरक्षा के लिए सैटेलाइट लॉन्च किया, उसके बारे में जानकारी, और जो जगहों में जहाँ पे कहीं ना कहीं किसी ना मतलब से कुछ चूक हो गई है कि हम समाज के हर एक घटक को एक साथ लेके नहीं चल रहे, उस पर विचार करने की ज़रूरत है.
इस आज के कार्यक्रम के माध्यम से हमने बहुत सारी हमने जैसे मैंने अभी बोला मिशन स्पेस है, तो दोनों ही बातों को एक मेटाफोर की तरह हमने यूज़ करके बहुत सारी स्पेसेस को रीडिफाइन और री इंक्लूड करने की, इंक्लूसिव कार्यक्रम है ये. इसमें हमने महिला शक्ति तो है ही, एक LGBTQ कम्युनिटी जो है जिसको हम लोग नॉर्मली भूल जाते हैं, और मेरे ख्याल से हर अलग अलग तरीक़ों से उनमें टैलेंट है, फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में भी है, राइटर्स में भी है, हर तरीके से है. हम उस टैलेंट को एक्नॉलेज करते हैं बल्कि उनकी पर्सोनास को एक्नॉलेज नहीं करते, जो बहुत ज़रूरी होता है. यदि आपका कोई, आप काम कर रहे हैं, आपको एक अनोनिमसली एक्सेप्ट करा जाए, पर आपकी उस पर्सनैलिटी को, आपकी एक वजूद को हम एक्सेप्ट ना करें, तो वो बहुत एक बड़े, एक भयानक सत्य है ये. लेकिन ये है, तो हम उस स्पेस को मेटाफोर बना के उनको भी वो एक स्पेस और एक प्लेटफॉर्म, हम कौन होते हैं देना चाहने वाले, हम चाहते हैं वो हमारे साथ आए, हम उनके साथ आए.
और लक्ष्मी ने बड़े दिन से जिनका बहुत कंट्रीब्यूशन रहा है सोसाइटी को लेकर, बहुत काम किया आपने कम्युनिटी को लेकर, और भी जगह काम किया.
जी जी, लक्ष्मी जी तो आचार्य महामंडलेश्वर तो हैं ही, एक डिफरेंट टाइप की उन्होंने स्पेस क्रिएट करी है, एक आवाज़ क्रिएट करी है, और उन वो कई भाषाएं बोलती हैं, और वो एक ऐसी भाषा बोलती हैं जो यूनिवर्सल है. वो प्यार की भी है, नॉलेज की भी है, और वो एक एक सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट मेरे ख्याल से वो भाषा वो बोलती हैं. और आई सल्यूट हर एंड आई एक्नॉलेज हर फॉर व्हाट शी इज़, हू शी इज़ एंड व्हाट शी रिप्रेजेंट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ नॉलेज मोर देन एनीथिंग
एल्स.
मेरे ख्याल से हम सिर्फ हैंड होल्डिंग कर रहे हैं लोग अपनी, क्योंकि वो सब बहुत सक्षम हैं, जितने लोग यहाँ पर आए हैं, जो नहीं भी आ पाए हैं, बहुत सक्षम लोग हैं, अपने 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 फील्ड में आर्टिस्ट हैं, क्रिएटिव लोग हैं, और उनको सिर्फ उनको हमारी और हमको उनकी हैंड होल्डिंग की ज़रूरत है. यही आज का शायद टेक अवे है सबसे बड़ा इस कार्यक्रम का.
नारी शक्ति सबसे मोस्ट पावरफुल शक्ति है. हम सब नारी से ही बाहर आए हैं, जितने भी हम लोग पैदा हुए, वेमेन हमारी मदर, एंड उसके ऊपर तो कोई शक्ति है ही नहीं, चाहे वो देवी माँ का रूप है. एंड जो ये जो इवेंट है, मिशन सैटेलाइट जो भी वहाँ पे हमारी गवर्नमेंट ने किया था, इट वॉज सक्सेसफुल एंड बहुत अपने आप में एक बहुत ही हिम्मत वाला काम था जो कर गई गवर्नमेंट, और अच्छा सक्सेसफुल भी हुए हम लोग. सो उसको जोड़ते LGBT कम्युनिटी के साथ, इट्स वेरी वेरी गुड कि इनफैक्ट मैं आज ही पास ये अलाउ, आई थिंक दिस अलाउड टू वोट, गवर्नमेंट इसे अलाउ किया हुआ सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने, राइट? इट्स अ वेरी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग मूव एंड आई टोटली सपोर्ट दिस. और ये बहुत अच्छी बात है कि इक्वल दर्जा दिया जा रहा है हर चीज़ में, एंड गॉड ब्लेस देम, बिकॉज ये भी हमारे जैसे इंसान ही है सब लोग, एंड आई टोटली सपोर्ट दिस. एंड थैंक्स टू ऐसे ऐसे कार्यक्रम हो रहे, इस तरह के मिशन हो रहे, रेशमा जी का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, उन्होंने मुझे बुलाया ऐसे इवेंट पे. सो दैट सर आपका फ़ोन बज रहा है सर. रेशमा जी का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, शी कॉल्ड मी फॉर दिस इवेंट. इसमें काफ़ी मुझे नॉलेज मिली, इज जस्ट हैव टू रश नाउ, मेरे को सुनना था पूरी इंद्रेश जी की बात सुननी थी, बट आई मिस दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी अभी.
सर इसके अलावा बहुत सारी बातें एयर कॉम्बैट को लेकर भी बताई गई.
ओके,
आपकी भी एक फिल्म आ रही है फौजी
कॉलेज,
ऐसा बताइए उस बारे में कितनी रिलेटेबल है स्पेशली इस इवेंट से.
फौजी कॉलिंग अभी अगेन ये इवेंट से रिलेटेबल नहीं कह सकते, मगर अगेन फौजी हर देश के, ये एक्चुअली जो मैं फिल्म कर रहा हूँ उसमें मैं, शर्मन जोशी, हम दोनों मेन लीड में, और ये फिल्म आई एम प्लेइंग टाइटल रोल फौजी का. दिस इज अबाउट एवरी फौजी. हर फौजी की कहानी पूरी दुनिया की, चाहे वो पाकिस्तान का सोल्जर है, पाकिस्तानी सोल्जर है, चाइनीज सोल्जर है, अमेरिकन सोल्जर है, इराकी सोल्जर है, इसराइली सोल्जर, क्योंकि ये एक परिवार की कहानी, एक फौजी के परिवार की कहानी की. वो देश की रक्षा कर रहा है, बॉर्डरों पर तैनात है फौजी, और उसके परिवार, उनका क्या, उनके बच्चों का क्या, कैसे फौजी बैलेंस कर रहा है अपनी लाइफ को बॉर्डर पर खड़ा होकर. रोज सोच रहा है कि पता नहीं आज ना मर जाऊँ, कल ना मर जाऊँ, ठीक है, ये 10 लोगों को मारूँ. मैं मौका ढूंढता भी है मारने का, पर वो भी नहीं चाहता कि मारे किसी को, बस गलत नहीं होना चाहिए देश के साथ, देश की सेवा कर रहा है फौजी. नो सो हमारी फिल्म इस मुद्दे पर है, वेरी वेरी इमोशनल फिल्म है, बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग मुद्दा है. इससे रिलेटेड ऐसा है कि डेफिनेटली गवर्नमेंट बहुत कुछ कर रही है फॉर डिफेंस, एंड मोदी गवर्नमेंट, बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट, एंड आई एम ग्लैड कि जो पुलवामा का भी हुआ था, एंड देन दे टुक गुड रिवेंज, ये सब चीज़ें जो हुई हैं, सो डेफिनेटली, एंड इनफैक्ट इंडियन आर्मी बहुत सपोर्ट कर रही है हमारी फिल्म फौजी कॉलिंग को, डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया.
मतलब ये एक ट्रिब्यूट होगी सभी फौजी
फैमिलीज को, जितने भी शहीद हैं उनके परिवारों, उन शहीदों को ट्रिब्यूट है उनके परिवारों के जरिए. दिस इज अ ट्रिब्यूट ऑफ फौजी कॉलिंग. थैंक यू फ्रॉम जय हिंद.
Work with wholeheartedly. I am more important when I see a smallest person working. And when I was, for example, my driver, when I am going home at 3 o'clock and I am asking him to come back at 8 o'clock in the morning, he was there at 7 o'clock. If I say that I have worked, he is working much more because he has to come at 6:30, he has to start. So he is more hard worker than me. So that's how the entire system worked. The entire team motivated us to work for. So it goes completely to the team. Again, it goes to the leader who motivated us, sir, for all to come. With this small introduction, I present the letter from Reshma, which came to me, was it was said that science in general, then Mission Shakti in particular. So I started with thought that most of you may be knowing what it is. I just picked up from some internet some points where I felt India was very strong historically. India is a very strong science nation, which was systematically subdued or closed or not known to people because of the external influence who wanted to dominate us. So they ensured that people do not know what our achievements are. We had a clear scientific achievement, scientific thinking prevailing before we had the dominance from the Western or the Gulf or whoever it has come to us. Before this entered into us, we had a very strong science, and I feel that India was the leader in science and technology. There is a transition phase that somebody tried to subdue it, but our culture and ethics were so strong. Today we are again emerging leader, and we will continue to be leader, and we'll be a world leader. And what he said that during our lifetime, I am not looking at lifetime, and I am looking at next 10 to 15 years. And with what is happening in this country, we will definitely achieve it. That's what I can say. So with this, let me start with the small presentation of mine. Our culture is of ethics. अपने पास वंस वी गिव वर्ड व्हाट माय फादर यूज्ड टू से, आप पर एक बार जबान से आप बात दिया, हाथ हस्ताक्षर का कोई नहीं है, जो जबान से बात दिया यू हैव टू स्टैंड बाय दैट. That's what entire Ramayana also is about. That's what India is about. That's what we are all about. We don't depend on this documentary, lawyer and courts. India is a land of philosophy. India is a land of science and technology and the order of life. We showed the world what the way of life is. We had strength from mathematics to medicine. Everything was available in India. If you look at mathematics, next. The symbols of mathematics, the decimal symbol, everybody knows it's India which has given to them. We are given the addition, subtraction using the digit zero. The binary number system came from India. 18th century, Tipu Sultan used rockets. And even if you see, that it may be the first instance of rockets he used in the world. Next. Medicine. Who doesn't know about Indian Ayurveda? And how effective it is. I think for this August Forum, it's not for me to mention. We had medical, we also performed the first plastic surgery and the cataract surgeries. This is what I thought briefly about India. India has got a long history. I am not the person who can speak about it, nor am knowledgeable. This is what I thought I should take out, think that I should speak before I speak my my presentation on Mission Shakti. And then what we did post-independence. Post-independence, many of the laboratories were formed, like the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research in 1942, the Indian Institute of Technology from IIT Kharagpur, which produced so many talented engineers for the country, the Bhabha Atomic Research Center, the Defense Research and Development Organization, the Indian Space Research Organization, Akashwani, the television broadcasting, the Tarapur Atomic Research Station was later on started in 1969. Independent India started with in the missile technology. As you have seen the video of DRDO, the first IGMDB program started by Dr. Kalam, where we started the commencement of the development of five types of missiles. Prithvi, it is a surface-to-surface missile which launched from any land can go and drop a payload in a land. It started with 150 kilometers, it ended with 250 kilometers and beyond. It was a completely indigenous missile, produced, delivered, deployed at the depots, and has been successfully tested by users in number of trials. It is also transformed into Dhanush, which was onto the naval platform using one of our vessels. Then Akash. Akash is a surface-to-air missile which can intercept any of the aircrafts. It has got a system where a radar picks up an area of an aircraft coming in, gives it to a command and control launches this missile. And this is already in production and in deployment in country. Not only that, it has got a huge export potential where the world is looking at it. Agni is a surface to surface but with a long range, and we have done up to 5000 kilometers range. Nag is an anti-tank missile. It's a very complex missile which is also now in a very advanced stage. It has passed through all the tests. It's in a very advanced stage. You have also seen the India's own light combat aircraft, which today is the fourth generation ready aircraft, and it is also has given very good edge to the Make in India process, and it is now inducted into the services. The first fully operational clearance has been given to it already. This is basically on the missile side. I'll just skip through some, quickly go through. I already said the government today is encouraging heavily on the Indian medicine, especially on the Ayurveda. Government also has given numerous subsidies to the corporate health sector, where today the health cards which are coming to place has made the growing research of health industry in India, both on the medical corporate, its idea was that every village should have a corporate hospital. So that's how the health to all, what I say, happy Indians should has come up in this. But also there's another theory going on that we should come up with a cinema or the sports or whatever it activities. The idea is 2050, there should be a scenario where people need not go to hospital at all. I think that was our culture. The private chain of healthcare providers are innovating, and the world-class technology is in India today. That's why the medical tourism has grown. Next. Everybody knows India is a land of agriculture, but the science and technology and the research contribution of agriculture in this country today is enormous. The Agriculture Research Institutes has come from the research to the farm, and it has ensured that India has given the highest yields and a large-scale farming takes place, which resulted that the forestry and fishing, we have got an economy of 18.53 trillion in last year. This is the advances which we made as an agriculture science itself. We have invested huge amount, about 8,500 crores in ethanol production, and we have started exporting sugar to China also. The first mega food park in Rajasthan was inaugurated in 2018, and agri-food startups received funding about 1.6 billion in US. The agriculture sector in India witnessed huge deals worth about 251 $1 million. This is actually changing the rural India. Software, I need not have to mention much. We are the global leaders now almost in the software industry. And India is now becoming a base where many of the software, core software development works also has started and commenced, and we are going to achieve leadership in the basic core software technology itself, the core engine I'm speaking about. Space research, where we are coming to slowly. I can trace back into 1920 when Dr. Mitra first conducted the experiments leading to sounding of the ionosphere. And then later, scientists like C.V. Raman and Meghna Saha contributed scientific research. And then, under the leadership of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, the Indian Space Research has set up. And today, Indian space research has achieved a world leadership in the space launches for the country. We have launched many of the satellites, and we also have witnessed in 2014 a full cryogenic engine being launched using GSLV D5 launch. In February 15, 2014, ISRO created history by launching 104 satellites from a single rocket. It also placed in 5th June 2017 a communication satellite GSAT-19 in orbit. This is the evolution of Indian space transportation system. We started with SLV, that's where Dr. Kalam was there, started it. We migrated to ASLV. The backbone today is the Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle and the Geosynchronous Launch Vehicle. It has not moved from the GSLV, moved from Mark 2 to Mark 3. India also went to interplanetary missions. We went to Chandrayaan and we used a very unique, we didn't send a direct rocket to Chandrayaan. We did a polar orbit, and from the orbit we did an orbital apogee, that is we changed the apogee, and as it moved up, it reached the moon. And similar technique we used the Mangalyaan machine, and Mangalyaan machine was a major breakthrough at a very low cost. We achieved what we can, it has shown India as a strength of space power. To intercept a satellite. A satellite moving at a low Earth orbit. The low Earth orbit are generally military satellites, and we need to demonstrate that we are to intercept it. What is a low Earth? Low Earth orbit satellite means satellite moving at a very lower orbits. Anything which is moving at above 100 kilometers altitude. That means it can take very close images of your place. It can exactly show what is located where. And 100 kilometers to 1000 kilometers, we call it low Earth orbit. And we have to intercept it. How do we intercept? One is we can go near, explode some explosion and other things. Other is intercepting it at a direct hit. Now you see, satellite is a very small object. And you consider in the space, it should be like a small point. Small point if you look at it, 250 kilometers, 300 kilometers. Now a small point object, we have sent a vehicle here, and that object has to be directly hit. It is like you are hitting with a small stone or something, a small bullet. I think it's much smaller than that. That is what we have to do it. Then it also has to intercept within few minutes after launch. Why? Because my radar picks up that satellite at certain point with the location. And from that point, I started calculating trajectory. The entire command sequence has to happen. There's no manual intervention. This has to lift off. So I got hardly 3 minutes to complete the activity. That is only the time frame available. So this is my objective of this mission. I think I'm clear. Something has to be taken to that, precise to that location, hit. And I have to measure how that is moving. And calculate its path. Tell somebody, tell the missile that this is the path you go. And this all has to be automatic, no human has to be involved. So this is the complexity. Leo satellite is the target class. We had made a vehicle with a three stage. Why we call it three stage? The first stage is the propulsion. Propulsion which takes it to some altitude. I cannot fill everything fully. It gives me mass, balances and other things. Then it separates out and drops down. And it goes in some path. Then there is a second stage propulsion that ignites. Propulsion is the one which, that is, if in a fuel burns inside the rocket, fuel expands, pushes the rocket up. Then the second stage burns. The second stage takes, manages it again, takes it towards the direction of the satellite. All this information comes from the ground radar, tells this mission, through the ground radar will tell it. That means we will send the position of the satellite to this body. And the body or the computer, the onboard computer will tell it to move further. We know that we start measuring the position of this vessel onboard continuously, and based on that it moves. Then after some part, this also drops down. Again, it cuts off. It drops down. Then we have the vehicle called, we called it as a kill vehicle. It's just a vehicle. Now, this has to be steered. So what we did, we had something like a heat protecting zone in the front, because there is an onboard sensor called image infrared seeker. What it does, image infrared means by the thermal image of the object, it says, it picks up by its own intelligence, this is the object I'm acquiring. It first takes the value from the ground radar, looks at the direction image. Now this object cannot withstand very high temperatures, which we have when the object is moving. So we have kept some kind of a... Next. So this is briefly about that. You have got a radar. You have got a satellite link through which we are giving it to a command and control center. We have a communication network which is launched. Now, they are all not located in one place. They are located around 2000 kilometers apart. Radar may be at one location. My command and control may be at Hyderabad. And my launch control may be at on the place where I have launched. Or it can be at some other place also. And launch may be at some other place. The entire is through a complete seamless fiber optic or a communication system which has. And this is what I am showing, the picture shows that. Next. And what I have explained now is the mission Shakti. Now, on the small screen, you see the point path. There is satellite coming path. There. Now, we have to choose this path also very carefully. See, if I do any other path, any of my object hits any of the landmass, there is going to be damage. So there is a safety corridor involved. So I have to, this satellite will not move every day on the same direction. It moves only on particular days in this direction. Other day it may come on a landmass itself, the way it moves. Because it's a polar synchronous vehicle, it moves around the poles. And it need not be have the same longitude every day. So it is important that I choose a path so that no damage occurs to any of the place. I choose a timing where the government has told the other aircrafts that you are not going to move, what we call not time. I choose an altitude so that the debris of this will not hit any other safe object. ISS may be traveling at some altitude, other things may be travel, it does not hit. So we had to be very careful on this, we had to do a lot of analysis, and we ensured, because not doing just a test is important, it is also that we follow the international doctrine. We do not affect any other international. If you see, after this test, nobody commented anything. So that the way the test was completely planned. What are the critical technologies of this sensor? What we have developed? I explained to you, hit to kill. So what we call guidance and control. Guidance is the way it has to go. Control is the method by which it has to make to go that place. Then image infrared seeker. We call it shutdown because it's a fixed seeker. And it picks up the pixel